VVTV. We're over at Collins and Moston Boxing Club, and I'm pleased to say I'm joined by Coach Rob Rimmer and
Billy Dennis.
Billy Dennis. I just saw you sparring there, Billy, with Lyndon Arthur, Commonwealth Light Heavyweight Champion. Some tough rounds, and you gave a really good account of yourself. Everyone in the gym was watching it. Tell us about how you got together then, Rob, and tell us about Billy and what you've got planned for him. He's not pro yet, I believe.
No, not yet. No, obviously Billy was he's a kickboxer, an unbelievable one. Like, you can tell him the record.
Amateur unbeaten, pro unbeaten. In amateur, I picked up 3 British, 3 English, 3 Europeans, and a world title.
So why boxing now?
You can only take kickboxing so far, and I think I took it to where I could. So my kickboxing coach told me, because I'm good with my hands, he just said, I think you should try the boxing, give it a go. He said, you've done what you can, so give it a go. Get everyone out there, show people what you can do. So I thought, why not? So came down to Colliers first. I was here first, met Lyndon and Zelfa and that. Was down at the amateurs, and then Pat saw me on the bag, brought me to the pros, and then I got on dead well. But cause I still carried on with my kickboxing then, and it was only just till last December I had my last kickboxing fight, and then I said I was going to turn over.
There's only one Robert Rimmer.
And then lockdown happened, and Rob's brother literally was 2 doors down from me, so I asked him could I do some pad work with Rob, and I just really enjoyed it. I loved the style, and that it suited me a bit more, so I thought I'll give it a try at the Robert's gym, and then I moved anyway down there, so it all worked out really, and I'm loving it there. Good set of lads. Fought a heavyweight in kickboxing too, so my advantage was, because I'm a bit smaller, I can move a bit as well. I'm a bit fast on my feet, so that was my advantage in the kickboxing, that I've got fast hands and I'm fast on my footwork. So
yeah, Rob, I wouldn't have, like I said, I wouldn't have thought he's got a real boxing style, hasn't he? Like a real Tyson-esque style.
But you know what, to be fair, he wasn't, I mean, he's talented. You know, if you look at him, you won't think, as soon as he lets his hands go, his movement, he's natural, he's got a talent. But it's been a work in progress, you know, coming from a kickboxing background.
Yeah.
You know, he was coming very square. So he's, you know, adapting and working on his footwork, his shape and stuff like that. But I mean, he's learning fast, and you've seen there today, you know, he's not fazed by jumping in with the likes of Lyndon, about inspiring with Jack Massey. And look, he's holding his own, and you know, as you've seen there, Fuller, you know, he's got all the ingredients to be a very, very good solid boxer. I think he's got a style that's exciting. People are going to love him. But like I said, yeah, he's a work in progress, mate, and I'm eager to get him to turn over, and let's see where we can take him.
Just turned 20.
Right. Young then, yeah, you've got a long time to this. So you achieved a lot when he was young.
This is the first year I've not fought since being 13. So I've always kickboxed, like tournaments, pro fights, so this is the first year I've not got out there, sadly. But
the thing is, though, as well, like, he's only just turned 20, he's a baby, really. You know, he's got years to work on stuff, but, you know, he's a lot more mature than most, you know, physically. He's got that strength, as you've seen, you know, he's... So I think, you know, he'll cause a lot of problems, both, you know, for whether we a couple of bouts first at heavyweight, you know, but hopefully we can bring down a cruiserweight. But he's a growing lad. But like you said, he's got all the attributes there to mix it with the best, you know what I mean? So it's going to be interesting.
I wouldn't have thought he was 20, you know, watching you in the ring there as well. Not at all, no. And, you know, the way you was working around with Lyndon there, it was some really good rounds. I think you've got
the
prospects on your hands here, Rob.
Yeah, mate. Yeah.
What's your sort of plans? How do you see the boxing going? I know it's sort of baby steps at the moment. You've not even sort of got a date when you're going to turn over. Things are up in the air as it is. But what is the immediate future for you?
Well, I'm just confident in what Rob's. I'm leaving it in Rob's hands, so I'm confident with Rob. So I wouldn't have stayed at the gym otherwise. So I'd rather come out 2 years time 100% than next year 50%. So I want to come out and fly through it. Like, as soon as I fight, I want everyone to know. Like, yeah. I'm coming.
We're in no rush whatsoever, you know, and he's already got a big, you know, social media following. You know, he's got a big fan base already, so there's no rush whatsoever. It's one step at a time, baby steps, and, you know, as long as he keeps improving, the main thing is, you know, build his profile, keep him learning, step him up as and when we need to. He's young, talented, he's got all the attributes, so there's no need to rush. You know, so just take one step at a time. But like, you know, Pat just said then at the end of it, you know, Ronaldo trainer, you know, and massive respect and words from him, you know, to Billy saying he's got all the ingredients to be a world champion. I think it's a massive statement coming from someone like Pat, you know, so he's got to take massive confidence from it. Not to get carried away, but doing all the right things, not in the gym, but out the gym, diet, all this. You know, he's learning on the job as well, so he's got a bright future.
So you've got to be following on social media. Before I forget, what is your social media?
It's Billy.Dennis, and Dennis is DENIZ.
AKA Turkish Tyson.
That's the name, apparently.
Yeah, Tyson. Yeah, I said you resembled a bit of the Tyson style there, the ducking and the left
hook. Yeah, yeah.
Why sort of boxing, martial arts, what is it about in your background? Was your family boxers, or, you know, how did you get into it originally?
No, not really. I just think when I was even a baby, my mum will tell you to this day, I was just, if the family come round, I'd be hitting them or something. I'd just be hitting them or like kicking them or doing something. I always wanted to go boxing, but there were a gym opened, a kickboxing gym, so my mum took me there, and then I just picked it up like nothing, and I just carried on, and I enjoy it. I love fighting. As like you said, I'm game. I'd rather step in with a world champion than someone else, because I think that's the best way to learn. But yeah, I just love it. I love the sport. I just love it all. Really, so.
Rob mentioned Pat was speaking to you, and I saw him come up to you in the corner, and then he was all chatting in the gym there. What was Pat saying? He's got Lyndon training here for this big fight with Anthony Yard, so it's great sparring as well for him. But what was he saying to you there, Pat?
He was saying I've got the ingredients to be a superstar, and he's told me that since he first seen me. Like, he seen me on the bag and he was amazed. So from that, coming from Pat and Rob and other people, like I've seen like Akib and stuff like that, they've all said it, so it's good for me to hear. It's like I must be doing something right, so it's just for me to stay on that path now and keep up the good work, really.
You're in a good place with Rob Rimmer at the Denton gym down there, Phoenix Camp. He's built up a great camp, haven't you? You've got some brilliant fights in there. You mentioned Jack Massey as well, he's got a big fight coming up. So you've been sparring with Jack,
that's been
really
Jack
good
out,
sparring
yeah.
as well.
That's what I mean, it's cruiserweight, I'm going to be fighting at cruiser, and Jack's one of the best out there, so it's good sparring on my doorstep, really. So. Yeah, I love it there.
What's it like at the Phoenix camp, and how has he settled in, Rob?
You've got to be able to hold your own at that gym. Yeah, we have a bit of banter, don't we?
Skin, you?
Yeah, it's all banter. Rob rits into everyone. The group chat just goes ping, 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 ping. Rob just going into everyone. But yeah, I've settled in well. I love it. I like our lads. All nice. So yeah.
How is Jack? He's got a big fight coming up. Tell us about that, Rob.
Yeah, you know, it was due to, originally it was going to be for the WBO European title. You know, there's been numerous opponents which the fight was offered to. They fell through for whatever reason or another, I don't know what, but we just had to, you know, remain focused with it. There's been a couple of date changes, but now we've got the date and we've got an opponent set. He's got a live opponent, 16 wins, 16 knockouts, one loss, one draw. So, you know, he comes with a credible threat, but he's more than ready, you know, to be fair. He's on fire, and I think he's going to make a big statement. He's got a window of opportunity to showcase his skills. And I think next year you'll see Jack really push on and hopefully, you know, start grabbing a few titles.
Since the React 4 fight, have you seen a change in him since that? I mean, he felt hard done by with the result. And
it's one of them where, you know, a lot of people could look at him, and I think everyone... voice the same opinion, you know, you should have been the winner on the night. But look, it's water under the bridge, you can only go away from it, learn from it. He'd only fought six rounds previous to going into that fight, so he's asked a lot of questions and answered them too. He's gone 12 rounds, he's still had plenty in the tank. So moving on now, you know, looking back, he's just full of confidence. He knows where he belongs, and, you know, he's just eager to push on. Like I said, it's been a long camp. I think you're going to see the best of him this time round. And again, you know, we'll push on, and we want the big fights. We want Chris Billingsmith, we want Tommy McCarthy. You know, these are all good, nice guys. They all get on together, but look, nothing personal, it's business, and that's all it is. And I assure you now, listen, next year you're going to see him dominate that cruiserweight division domestically, 100%.
You've been sparring with him,
yeah.
Really. How's he looking? How's he
sharp, you know. When I first started sparring, he's really come on now. I can feel him. He's like, he's strong, he's fast, he's listening more. I'm very awkward, me, so he's so I think he's coping better. He's more switched on now, he's thinking more. But he's redder. He's been ready for it. It's been a long camp for him, but it's worked out better really, hasn't it?
Yeah. And so, I think just overall, Jack, I mean, going back to your question then, since that last fight, I just think he's matured a lot as well. You know, and his self-belief, again, his confidence. Not just what I tell him, but what everybody else, you know, randomers, people that don't know him, people in boxing. So, you know, he's full of confidence. He's an happy fighter, makes a dangerous fighter. So, like I said, mate, you're going to see it.
Yeah, fulfill his the potential and talent.
Yeah, definitely, 100%.
What else in the gym's happening, Rob? Any other fights you're preparing for?
Do you know what? I've just got a date for. I've got a featherweight, Josh Holmes. He's been sparring, done a few rounds with Elf yesterday. Super talent. His kid's got, honest to God, like, I mean, you ask anyone about him, he's a super talent. And I've managed just to, Kevin Marie's manager has managed to get as a date on the Dennis Hobson bill, which is hopefully going to be announced this week. So he'll get back out and again next year, push him on. And I think he'll be fast tracked because he's really, really talented kid. Like he excites me as well. You know, like he does, like you've got that exciting style. They've got that something. And, you know, I can't wait to get going with him.
Yeah,
honestly, he's meant to watch.
I've got a few. It's just the case with all this pandemic and coronavirus, you know, obviously in an ideal world, if, you know, once the lads are active and busy, you know, I'd be an absolute buzz in the gym, but we've got a couple more in there at the moment where it's probably going to look like next year. But again, mate, the gym's buzzing at the moment. It's buzzing. Got a good set of lads, so I'm fortunate enough to have them, you know what I mean?
Yeah. No, I'm glad to hear that. Glad the gym's doing well. It's always, I've not been down for a bit, but I will get down.
Yeah.
See, as it's always good to go over there. I've been going there for years when your dad had it.
Yeah.
Prior to that, Billy and that, wasn't it? So yeah. How is your dad, by the way?
He's good, mate. Yeah. He's up in Blackpool, just doing little bits with Brian and that still. And he's just cracking on doing his pigeons, yeah. Pigeon mad.
Good guy, your dad. Yeah. Give him my regards,
yeah,
please,
course,
if you see him.
Yeah, of course, I will.
Actually, I'll send him a message as well.
Yeah.
I'll remember. It's good to see you. It's great to meet you, Billy. I wish you all the very best going forward, and I'm sure it's not the last I'm going to hear of
100%.
Big Billy.
Cheers, Chris. Thanks very much, mate.
Nice one. Nice. Catch up with you soon.
Cheers, mate.
Cheers, Rob.